quick ratio, return on equity, return on investment, price per earnings, do these say anything to you? In this video, I will show you 10 important financial ratios and what they mean. What's up guys, welcome to the episode 4 of Investing in the Stock Market for Beginners series. If you haven't seen the first 3 episodes, a playlist can be found in the description. If this is your first time here, take care of your finances by clicking the subscribe button. In this video, I will show you 10 important financial ratios and what they mean. Financial ratios are relative magnitudes of two selected numerical values taken from a company's financial statements. They show us information like how profitable, liquid, efficient, and how much debt the company is using as a leverage. All this information helps you to know if the stock is worth buying and is the share price correctly valued. Before we get started, comment down below what financial ratios do you use the most to invest. Also, let me know if you think I didn't mention some financial ratio that you think is very important. Let's get started with number 1, gross margin percentage. Gross margin is a company's net sales revenue minus the cost of goods sold. This shows the amount of sales revenue that the company keeps from sales after the direct costs associated with the product has been removed. Direct costs means things like material and labor needed to produce the product. The higher the gross margin percentage is, the more the company keeps on each dollar of sales made. Gross margin is calculated by the formula gross margin equals net sales revenue minus direct costs. Gross margin percentage is calculated by dividing the gross margin with the net sales revenue and multiplying the answer with 100. Let's say that our company Orange sells phones $100 each and the direct costs of the phone are $60 each. If we sell 10 phones, our net sales revenue is $1,000. The direct costs are $600. So the gross margin is $1,000 minus $600 equals $400. The gross margin percentage is $400 divided by $1,000, which equals to 0.4. 0.4 multiplied with 100 equals 40%. So every dollar we get from our sales, we keep 40 cents. Financial ratio number 2, net profit margin. Net profit margin shows the percentage of sales that has turned into profits. It shows company's bottom line after all other expenses have been included. So in this one, you don't only count the direct costs, you count every expense from taxes to salaries. So let's imagine that we are selling the phones again. First, we make $100. Then we deduct the direct costs, which were $60. The $40 left is a gross margin. Now we pay indirect costs, meaning things like researching, marketing, and so on. Let's say the indirect costs are $20, so now we minus the $20 from the $40, which equals $20. This is an operating margin. Now we pay $5 interest on our debt, and the $15 left is the pre-tax margin. After we pay our taxes, which are $5, we are left with the net margin, which is $10. Now to calculate the net profit margin, we divide the net income with our sales revenue. $10 divided by 100 is 0.1. This multiplied with 100 is 10%, so the net profit margin for our company is 10%. Financial ratio number 3, quick ratio. The quick ratio tells how well the company is able to pay its short-term obligations. Because it's used for a short term, it uses only liquid assets, meaning assets that can be easily converted into cash. These assets are cash and cash equivalents, marketable securities, and accounts receivable. When we divide these assets with current liabilities, we get the quick ratio. If the quick ratio is over 1, it is a good sign the company is able to pay its current liabilities. So if our company's cash liquid assets are worth $1 million and current liabilities are worth $1.2 million, our quick ratio is 0.8333. This means that we are not able to pay back our current liabilities, which is usually a bad thing. Financial ratio number 4, current ratio. The current ratio also tells us how well a company is able to pay its obligations. The formula for this one is different than what it was for quick ratio. Current ratio is calculated by dividing current assets with current liabilities. This means that we also include those assets that are not easily converted to cash. The higher the current ratio is, the better. There is no single number to be looking for, the current ratios vary from industry to industry. If the number is less than 1, it means that the company is not able to pay its short-term obligations well. So if our company's current assets are $1.5 million and current liabilities are $1 million, our current ratio is 1.5. This is over 1, which means that we should be able to pay our short-term obligations without problems. Financial ratio number 5, debt to equity ratio. The debt to equity ratio shows us how much leverage a company uses. It shows us how much of the company's operations is financed with debt and how much is financed with owned funds. The ratio is calculated by dividing total liabilities with total assets. For example, if our company has $1 million worth of assets and $500,000 worth of liabilities, the ratio would be 0.5. This multiplied with 100 gives us 50%. This means that our debt ratio is 50%, which means that half of our assets are financed through debt. If the ratio is less than 50%, more of the assets are financed through equity. If it's more than 50%, most of the assets are financed through debt. Financial ratio number 6, return on equity. Return on equity is a financial ratio that tells us how effectively companies' assets are used to create profits. You should compare the return on equity with other companies. For example, S&P 500 average long-term return on equity is 14%. So if a company's return on equity is 10, it is pretty bad. If it's over 20%, it's very good. The formula for calculating this is dividing net income with equity. If our company's net income is $1 million and the equity is $10 million, the return on equity is 0.1, aka 10%. So it's less than S&P 500's average. Financial ratio number 7, return on investment. Return on investment shows us how efficiently an investment is doing compared to how efficiently other different investments are doing. So with this financial ratio, you can compare whether or not you want to invest and if other investment possibilities are better. The formula for this ratio is the net profit divided by the cost of investment. Let's say that our company Orange has a net income of $1 million and the investment is $10 million. The return on investment is 0.1, aka 10%. Now our competitor Banana has a net income of $1.5 million and the investment is $10 million. The return on investment is 0.15, aka 15%. So which company do you think is better to invest in? That's correct. Well done. Financial ratio number 8, return on assets. This financial ratio shows how profitable a company is relative to its total assets. It tells us how efficiently the company's assets are generating earnings. The formula for return on assets is the net income divided by the average total assets. This ratio is useful for comparing companies in the same industry, and it also varies across different industries. So in this example, our company Orange has a net income of $1 million and average total assets of $10 million. This means that the return on assets is 0.1, aka 10%. Financial ratio number 9, earnings per share. Earnings per share shows a company's profit divided by the amount of shares of common stock. The higher the company's earnings per share is, the more profitable it is considered. There are many different formulas for EPS, but the basic formula is net income minus preferred dividends divided by the weighted average common shares. Weighted average means that you take amount of shares this year plus the amount of shares last year and divide that by 2. So if our company Orange had 110 shares last year and this year we only have 90 shares, the weighted average is 110 plus 90 divided by 2 equals 100. If the net income is $1,000 and preferred dividends are $500, the earnings per share would be 1,000 minus 500 divided by 100 shares, which equals $5 earnings per share. Financial ratio number 10, price to earnings ratio. This financial ratio is used for valuing the company. It shows if the share price accurately represents the projected earnings per share. Good thing that you now know what earnings per share means, because the formula for price to earnings is market value per share divided by earnings per share. So if our company Orange is a publicly traded company and the price of a share is $10 and our earnings per share is $1, the price to earnings ratio is $10 divided by $1, which equals 10. This means that you are investing $10 for every dollar of earnings. This financial ratio also tells that how long it should take you to get your investment back. In our example, it will take 10 years to get the $10 investment back. The lower the PE ratio is, the faster you will get your investment back. Congratulations! Now you know how to calculate 10 different financial ratios for the stock market. There are dozens more, but I only included these 10 for now. Comment down below if you watched it this far and feel free to ask any questions, I will answer all of them. The cool thing about financial ratios is that you don't have to remember all these formulas, because many websites calculate these ratios for you. For example, the website investing.com has a lot of different financial ratios for stocks calculated, so you can check the link in the description if you want to see how your favorite companies are doing. While you don't have to calculate everything by yourself, it is still important that you understand what all these ratios mean and how they are calculated. Next week's episode will be the last of this series, and it will help you make your first investment. While you wait for that, you might want to check out my recent book summary on what Robert Kiyosaki teaches about becoming an ultimate investor in his book, Rich Dad's Guide to Investing. Smash that subscribe button so you don't miss out next week's episode. Have a nice day, and I'll see you later.